Guys, you know who it is? It's Junior, Dell, Hagen, reporting in with a really good pump. And listen, guys, I get it. Training is not about the pump, nor should it be about the pump. Because the pump ain't going to lead to sustainable goal gains over a long period of time. You understand what I'm saying? Like, the majority of people that are watching the YouTube fitness vids and stuff like that, you're looking for a way to get to what, that 315 bench, right? That 405 squat, that 495 dead. All right, and that's all strength. I mean, if you're training for a pump, those numbers ain't gonna come. But there comes a point in time where you need to throw yourself a curveball, okay? Where you need to maybe change up your approach to training to keep it interesting. Well, français. Keep it interesting, okay? Keep you engaged, give you goals, give you a reason, give you motivation. Okay, see, Rick Del Hagen right here. Rick Del Hagen. Ow! Right here. Jeez. Okay. Had knee surgery a while back. I'll tell you guys right now, today I was medically cleared. That means that for all of y'all asking, Rick Del Hagen, when are you gonna debut in NXT? Well, listen guys, I wasn't medically cleared. So at this point in time, the ball can get rolling now. I can get back in the ring, I can train, and I can get to that next stepping stone. All right, with that being said, a lot of you guys are like, Rick Del Hagen, get back to the intensity and the mindset. Are you gonna do the searchers again? Blah, blah. Guys, I wasn't even medically cleared. You think I'm gonna be a doofus and push my body to the absolute limits when the joint integrity is not even 100%? You guys gotta think. Some of you guys, a lot of you guys are smart. You got very high IQs. You understand what I'm saying? I like that. And for you low IQ individuals, that's okay too. But when you ask questions like that, you just gotta think. You gotta take a couple steps back. You gotta be like, wait a second, Rick Del Hagen had major reconstruction of his knee. I'm talking tendons and ligaments, bones, tissue of all sorts, drills and screws, bamboozled with nails and hammers, things of that sort. Okay, you gotta take that step back and ask yourself that. But anyways, my whole point, guys, is some of you are like, well, don't get into bodybuilding, Rick Del Hagen. Stay true to the strength. Listen, guys, nobody likes strength more than old Rick Del Hagen. I think you guys should know that by now. All right, but there comes a point in time when you got to ask yourself, well, listen, I had major reconstructive surgery, and I'm in a business that's an upper body business where you can make gazillions of your upper body, of your swollenness, of your stack and jack, okay? So it's a no-brainer, right? Anyways, what am I even getting at here, guys? I'm getting at, I've thought of an approach that I don't think anyone else has thought of. And I'm saying that right now. I am a pioneer. I'm sorry, I'm just gonna say it, I'm gonna call it like it is. I'm a pioneer. A pioneer of hypertrophy. The mad muscle physicist. You understand? Guys, I've always been a numbers-driven guy. Goal-oriented, right? And I think a lot of you are the same way. You're driven by the numbers. You're driven by goals. And it's great for strength, right? But if you're making gains, I mean, it's so one-dimensional. And that's I just realized that the other day. There's some good stuff coming up in terms of content, video content, that led me to this conclusion. It was kind of a joke, but then I thought about it for a second. Wait, this is actually, it's actually brilliant. You should approach your training in a numbers-driven manner, right? You want to shoot for that 405 squat or whatever. So maybe yesterday you got 315 for two. Maybe today's 315 for three, or maybe it's 320, whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, approach it. You should do that. But then maybe after you do that, or maybe you're burnt out from pure strength training and you want to throw that curveball. Guys, you get yourself one of these. Yeah? Like $3-4 at Walgreens. $3-4. $3-4 brand spanking new. You get yourself one of these, and you measure your arms, or you measure your torso, you know, the wings, the chest, or you measure your thigh, or your calf, whatever it may be, whatever it is that you're training that particular day, or whatever your goal is, and you just shoot for getting the most volume, or the sickest pump, or even the most inflammation, because that's all training really is, right? It's this exercise-induced inflammation, this reaction that causes this whole rebuilding process, all these metabolites, things of that sort. You get yourself one of these, and it's funny, the other day I had a couple guests over here, and we were doing this, and it was kind of a joke, but it wasn't, right? And we were measuring. Wow, yeah. And my top measurement was 52. All right, well today, I did the exact same thing. Tape measure, you know what? Let's put the fun aside, let's put the laughs and the giggles aside, and let's go full ham bone. And let's see the biggest we can get. So I'm talking pressing, I'm talking pulling, I'm talking the whole shebang-a-bang, and I got to 52 and a quarter, man. 52 and a quarter, okay? So what do you think I'm gonna do tomorrow, or the following day, or the following day? Because this is fresh, and this is exciting. You best believe I'm going for 52 and a half. And whether it may be exercise, or maybe it's the diet, maybe it's all these other factors though, but doing that, you're gonna figure out what exactly it takes to induce the biggest myotropic, I can't even think of the word right now, positive, whatever, balance of swellness, sodium retention, glycogen, agua, all that stuff. Now you start picking the pieces of all the factors. This is how you increase growth. And I told you guys at the very beginning of the video, the pump is not the key, but nobody can deny the fact that the pump has its place in time. Flushing metabolites, growth factors, things of that sort, to get to that little next level in terms of hypertrophy. Let me restate, strength is number one, but the pump and all that stuff comes afterwards, and it's not like it's all strength or nothing, okay? Everything is a tool. So this is just another way to finally approach a pump style, bodybuilding style, whatever it may be, but actually goal driven as opposed to a gazillion reps looking in the mirror. I can't tell. I think I look good every day. Would you do the same thing with strength training? Would you put blind weights on? And I think that felt pretty heavy. Maybe that was the best day I've ever had. Oh, wait, I think that felt pretty heavy. That was good. Never knowing what you're lifting? No, you know the numbers. So every single day, every single session, you know the numbers. You're checking it out. Pre-workout, intra-workout, post-workout. You gotta be in tune, in perfect key, G sharp, with your body. All right? Like I said, that's Ricky Sticky Judas Del Hagen giving you guys the most groundbreaking, innovative bro science known to man.